allow them to practice with their, when they were practicing for a team. Mm-hmm. And as you know, and you'll probably find out.
Heard stitched together by those that spoke this morning was it's a Coast Guard story and it's a football story, but it's really an American story. You know, it's about the exceptionalism of our country, and it's exceptionalism, you know, when you think about Emlen Tunnell, whose life was way too short at 50, a little over 50 years, a half century, but Garrett Hill, local guy, you heard the story, read about how he grew up, and that was a little bit of multiculturalism, but he was at the tail end of the Jim Crow era, you know, that kind of went into the early 1950s. And here's a guy that, you know, grew up like every kid in the neighborhood, wanted to be a Radnor, Red Raider, and played football there. And he did that. And I don't think he did that other than he wanted to go be like every other kid that grew up in Garrett Hill, to just put his skills and athleticism on the ball field, be the best he can. And then he was really exceptional at it. And then, you know, goes off to University of Toledo and plays college ball, which was a little bit unique in the period of time for someone of his background and his color. And breaks his back. You know, there's the call of the nation at war, and he wants to serve his nation. And rejected by the Army and the Navy, you know, the neck injury, and I'm not sure if there's other underlying reasons here, but the Coast Guard saw the wherewithal to say, hey, come join our team. And while he served in the Coast Guard, you know, he was over in Papua New Guinea in 1944 when the USS Etiman, the ship, was cargo ship that he was assigned to, comes under attack by Japanese aerial torpedoes. They were loading 6,000 tons of, or 6,000 pounds of ammunition and fuel, and there's a huge hole in the side of the ship. And one machinist mate was rescued by one first-class steward mate, Emlen Tunnell. It was Fred Shaver. He was the only person in the engine room that survived that day, because Emlen raced in and grabbed him and put the flames out of his hands, burned his hands severely, and dragged him to higher level medical care on the ship, the sick bay. And that's the first bit of heroism. I mean, think about that. Emlen Tunnell was a first class steward's mate. He was a steward's mate because that's what you could do as a black member of the Coast Guard and the Navy back in those days. He didn't have a choice. In subsequent years, there were some that saw foot and integrated the services, but that was his choice. And it was his choice to go in and rescue a shipmate. And, you know, the words of Shaver's daughter are pretty impactful about, you know, they grew up with the Emlen Tunnell name as part of their family history. They realized that they would not be the Shaver family without his heroics. And then you fast forward to 1946, up in the waters off of Newfoundland, 32 degree water, when another shipmate, this time the shipmate falls into the water. It wasn't under attack. 32 degree water, Emlen Tunnell did what great Americans, great Coast Guardsmen, great service members do. He had a bias for action. He was offense on defense. He jumped in the water and he pulled his shipmate to rescue at great personal risk and peril, but that's what he was. He's a great American. And I think what I'm excited about is the merger of these stories. You know, we talked about history and our designee from the school, thanks for your words, and a coach and a dad, and we all reflect on that. And you know, and I think as you do get older, as you rise in ranks in the service, you know, I sat in your seats, just doing your job, you're just being young guys, you got your families, you got your work, you're excited. And you start to realize the importance of the history of an organization. For us, you know, September 27th, just recently, was the 79th anniversary of the death of Douglas Monroe, who pulled off a battalion of the Chesapeake Marines from Guadalcanal. We know that story. The Marines know our history better than us. Skip Bowen here with Thad Allen, back when Skip was the Master Chief and Thad was the 23rd Commandant of the Coast Guard. I got the number right, Skip?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. You know, they had this great idea about how does an organization that's not really in tune with its own history elevate that? And they thought about this class of cutters, the fast response cutters, Sentinel-class. And we're gonna name it after different things. The first, then they came back and said, how about we recognize our history and really look at our enlisted heroes predominantly? And here we are today. So we are stitching sort of the best of the Coast Guard history and the best men and women that served and are part of that history with an NFL great, Emlen Tunnell. And you know the story, six-time All-NFL, two-time national football champ on two different teams, the Packers and the Giants, 9-time Pro Bowler, first full-time assistant black coach in the NFL on two teams. And he went to the Hall of Fame as the first defenseman and the first black African-American. And I'll tell you, what a great merger of stories. And I think what it really goes down to at the core, just a great American.
Everybody look at me.